So you better think about something. Mm-hmm. Okay. Psalms 101. And we're going to pick up at verse 4. Go ahead.
A froward heart shall depart from me.
Mm-hmm.
I will not know a wicked person.
So this is the Lord speaking. Go ahead.
Whoso privately slandereth his neighbor,
mm-hmm.
him will I cut off.
Don't sound too good, do it. Mm-hmm. Why? Because that's a commandment. Don't bear false witness. So back in the day, they would cut you off. Now the Lord is going to take care of you because you slandered your neighbor. You brought about something that was not true against your neighbor. Okay, go ahead.
Him that hath an high look mm-hmm. and a proud heart will I not suffer.
And you know, that's where normally it come from. Because somebody's pride has been hurt, they ready to slander somebody else or tell a lie on somebody else or try to bring somebody else down, and it's not right. What you have to do is if somebody hurt your feeling or they, because bottom line, most of the time, they done brought you a truth, and that's what hurt. And instead of you accepting that truth, you start going about, you know, name calling. Then you go about, you know, slandering that person, and you going into a bigger pit than you was in before. But all you got to do is just accept it, believe it, and walk with it. And you be done. But our people, not Israel, they look for a fight. They look for a contention. But like I say here, it's the proud in heart that's going to start this thing off. Because when that pride get in, it's hard to bring them down. Okay, but go ahead.
Verse 6.
Mm-hmm.
Mine eyes shall be upon the faithful of the land,
uh-huh.
that they may dwell with me. He that walketh in a perfect way, he shall serve me.
Uh-huh.
He that worketh deceit shall not dwell within my house.
So now, you know what deceit is? Somebody that's deceptive. So if you work deceit, the Lord said you ain't getting in his house. He ain't letting you in there if you proud or you puffed up or you slander people. You ain't getting in. And I know people say, well, Brother Marlon, sometimes you seem arrogant. Well, I apologize. Now you got to move on. What we going to deal with now? I put mine out on a national public level. What you going to do? I'm ready to learn from this and move on. Because if I ever seem arrogant or puffed up, I apologize. But we got to move on. Okay, but go ahead.
He that telleth lies should not tarry in my sight.
So now, this we reading book here. And if you find people that's going about doing things contrary to the word of God, or people lying or slandering somebody, it ain't got to be about the Bible. It could be about anything. Because sometimes, you know, women get upset because another woman took their man and they start talking about this other woman. Brothers get upset because some man and messed him up on the basketball court and he made him look bad. Now you're going to talk about the brother's, you know, family and all that. Get away from that. Get away from that because you are not a humble and upright servant if you walk that way and call yourself Christ-like. Because you got to walk in his ways and not man. Plain and simple. Okay. Now, let's go to Proverbs 14 chapter. I did mention you put a mark in, put you something in Proverbs because we're going to be in and out the Proverbs all day. Proverbs 14 and verse 15. Go ahead.
The simple believeth every word,
mm-hmm.
but the prudent man looketh well to his going.
So now, the simple believe every word. Somebody come to them and they say, well, you know, this brother did this, this brother did that. The simple believe it. Don't check it out. And they'll run with that lie, or they'll run with that slander, or they run with that sowing discord, and they'll tell everybody else, and then, you know what? Trouble come about. But it say the prudent man looketh well to his going. Because I'm not going to go out here and say this brother did something wrong, and I don't check it out. I remember years ago, a brother did something, and I respected that brother. When I heard something went down with this brother, I called him on the phone. And I said, brother, is it true? And he said, yeah. And I said, you know, brother, I'm hurt. Because I expected more out of you. And it's the same thing we got to do for all our teachers. We all flesh. But we better check it out before we believe somebody else. Because it could be hearsay, because somebody could be slandering for no reason. But go to the source. If you don't go to the source, don't say nothing. Get your proof, get your facts before you jump on the bandwagon and try to put a person down or convict somebody for something and it ain't right. And believe me, I try not to get involved in these things, but they ask, some people call me and ask me to get involved. So if they call me and ask me to get involved, I get involved. But I don't want to. I got my own troubles. I got my own issues. I don't need to add more to that. Because this is stressful when brothers attack other brothers or sisters attack other sisters. It's stressful. And it's something we shouldn't have to deal with. Period. Okay? Now, let's go to Proverbs 29th chapter. And I know if y'all first time here, y'all say, man, that teacher, boy, he tried to be so emotional. But I don't remember one other time I was like this, and that was years ago when I did a lesson on the workers of the Lord. Because I work for the Lord. And I wish everybody would work as much as I work or put in as much time as I put in, but I know it ain't for everybody to do it that way. The Lord give you the meat that you're going to use to bring in the fruit in, and that's what you bring in with. But it just bothers me when people have an opportunity to do something and don't do nothing. So that's what bothers me. Because you can do the service of the Lord. And he say it's a reasonable service. He don't ask you for a lot, just a reasonable time from you to get his word out. Plain and simple. Okay. Now, where we at? Proverbs 29 and verse 22. Go ahead.
An angry man stirreth up strife, and a furious man aboundeth in transgression.
Now, if he always run around angry, he ain't doing nothing but stirring up strife. And we can see this all day long, in Israel. They're just angry all the time. Want to step off into a fight, want to step off into contention, want to do something. If they ain't fulfilled with something being contrary for the day, they upset. And they're going to look for a fight tomorrow. But he said, an angry man stirreth up strife. Okay, go ahead.
A man's pride should bring him low.
What gonna bring you low?
It's pride.
Your pride. Because we can get a little puffed up sometimes, think we ain't never wrong, or we know everything, or we got it all. You see, your pride is what's gonna bring you down. Plain and simple. Okay, go ahead.
But honor shall uphold the humble in spirit. But
honor. That's where you get your pride from, or you wanna be proud of something, is based on your honor. And I know if you walk around here with a good name, can't nobody affect that name. Can't nobody take that from you because the Lord got you on his credit list. He got your name in the book. You ain't got to worry about man. I'm going to show you a prophet in here today. He was worried about man, but then you know what? And he said, I'm going to shut up. I ain't going to say nothing. But he realized what he had was bigger than man. And he couldn't shut up. Okay, but go ahead. That was it. Now, let's go to Ephesians, the 4th chapter. Ephesians 4. And, you know, like I say, sometimes we always think we getting beat up by people, you know. And then some people say, well, you know, I don't know no camps like me. And, you know, I'm not in this to be loved by anybody. You know, I go to different places and everybody hate me. Well, if you go to different places and everybody hates you, maybe you got something wrong. Maybe you need to recheck yourself. Because somebody should love you, because I know, you know, somebody in here love me because they believe in the same thing I believe in.